Welcome back to the Rhode Show. This morning in the buzz, now that the blizzard of 2013 has passed, fingers crossed, everyone is ready to share their stories about how they made it through it. From thousands without power to those just plain snowed in for the weekend, we want to know how everyone fared during the storm. I can tell you, yes. I had a bunch of people over Friday night just to like hang out for a little while, and they weren't supposed to stay, but the plow kept, they parked their cars, their trucks, and one plow went by, another plow went by, and kept going, one right after the other, and then I went out to take the dog out, and I said, guess what, everybody? I said, I know you planned on going home.
So for those that stayed at Will's house, you were unwanted.
No. No. I just didn't think that we were going to have, like, everybody, like, stay. I knew that they were going to come over, like, maybe have a drink, maybe have something to eat. But I didn't know I was going to have, you know, like, they were, like, four adults. We had, like, eight kids.
Oh, my goodness.
Yeah.
And slumber party.
And then the snow kept piling up, and the plow would go by, and one plow would
pile
go by.
Up even more.
So I went out, and I said, everybody needs to get comfortable because nobody's going anyplace. We're hunkering down, which I was glad because we were all together and everybody had
exactly.
a lot of fun.
And then they went out to their car and were like, well, good thing we brought this overnight bag.
Yeah.
Right?
Yeah.
I just happened to have a sleeping
You know, it here. Really was weird. Some did have an overnight bag, now that you mention it.
Well, probably if they were going out, you just wanted to, you know,
just be prepared.
Be safe. And
right.
Speaking of being safe, I was actually when, you know, we lost power and in turn we lost our heat. We weren't alone. My grandmother actually lost her heat as well. So we decided, okay, get all the dogs together. We're going to pick up my grandmother. We're all going to go to our relative's house. They had everything. And so we get to my grandmother's street, and we can't turn down it.
Oh,
check
no.
this out. I actually shoveled probably,
Look at you.
Probably 50 yards from the start of her street all the way down, up, and this is my grandmother, from her doorway, I shoveled up to her door
alone
to now walk, yes, by myself. Keep in mind, there is a man next door with a snowblower. Watch me do this. There were two kids hired to shovel out the driveway next door. Watch me do this.
Yeah.
So here I am, and keep in mind, what else was I going to do? So I'm shoveling and just thinking, this is a story. This is one for the books.
Oh, yeah.
Shoveled up to her door, had to now walk her down the street to the car. But
was it a piggyback ride?
Suffice it to say, it was not a piggyback
not
ride.
Not piggyback,
but
okay.
It was, please do not slip.
Yeah, don't
on this
slip.
Path that
yes,
I
that is yes. so scary.
Because then she's going to sue you.
That would be an interesting
That'd
one.
Be bad.
But no, so that was just, I mean, it's things like that. It's stories that are forever going to be in your mind. Like, remember when I shoveled down Grammy Street?
Right.
Oh, yeah.
Well, yeah, Will mentions the blizzard of 78. So it's like, you know, well, I'm sorry, guys.
Well, the rest of us were suffering.
Yes. Well, you guys were suffering. We didn't lose power.
Thanks.
I know. But you know what? You're very fortunate. And
I know. And it was my parents' home. I don't know what's going on at my apartment, but we fared fine.
Right.
Thankfully, we had a fire, but we were checking in on our relatives and our friends and making sure that everyone was okay. But I'm sorry.
Just for the record,
fun.
She didn't check on me till Sunday at around 3:30. How you doing?
They don't yet. And you want to know why? Because she was doing this activity.
Yes. Look what she's doing.
What were you doing? You got to do what you got to do.
There she is. Woo!
We're sledding.
I'll check on them later, but first I'm going to toboggan. Here
that's
I go
my,
again.
That's my dad pushing me, and I'm almost smashing into my mom on the
phone. That's good. Here's another lawsuit.
There it is.
Another family lawsuit.
Did I mention I'm in my late 20s?
That's all right.
It was fun. We have this luge that my parents got me years and years and years ago. So broke that out.
Right.
Had fun. Then I went in, got my hot cocoa, and checked on you, Will, and Kayla, sent you guys some messages on Facebook.
Yeah.
But no, I mean, I hope everybody is doing okay.
Yeah.
It was tough. Guys, they love, like, the equipment and stuff like that. I had the snowblower going, which was fun. But even that got old.
Tough.
That got old real quick, and it was still tough trying to get through because it was a layer of ice underneath.
And you know, I gotta say thank you too to all those people who have been hard at work.
Sure.
I mean, the highways are pretty clear. Main roads are, for the most part, look pretty good today.
Yeah.
But also, I mean, my heart goes out to those families of the people that were out working.
Because they were out all the time.
Needless hours, including, you know, the people at our station too. So.
Absolutely.
Thank you very much.
There was
and
a
like
lot
I
of togetherness.
Said,
there was a lot of togetherness here at Cattamore Boulevard over the weekend.
Lots
of togetherness.
And all over Rhode Island. Yeah.
The other thing, we had the generator going, which I was very thankful to have the generator, but I had bought this thing 2 years ago, and everybody's like, oh, what do you need a generator for? What do you need a generator for? I said, that day is going to come, and I'm going to take that generator out and power it up. Guess what? Friday was that day.
And
so I was so happy. I started that thing. And they were at my place.
All your guests were probably
they were at my place. I was very happy to have it. Although, you know, it only goes so far, but it was a good day. My kids, by the way, deserted us, and they were stealing Wi-Fi from a company that was close by because they could get free Wi-Fi. They were hunkered up in their bedroom like they were wanted by the police, texting and everything else because they need to be connected.
Well, someone mentioned online on Facebook, like, got to get Megan Moody in there to do some crafts. I'm like, they've got the Wi-Fi now. Like, yeah. They're good.
Basically, you've admitted to having unwanted guests and your daughter's stealing Wi-Fi.
They were stealing Wi-Fi. Hey.
Totally positive.
I'm going to be taken out by cops by the private investigator.
Right. Well,
how do you
at least you didn't
that?
Abandon them. They abandoned you, I guess.
There was thought of it.
Well, we also asked our Facebook friends and our followers on Twitter how things went for them during the storm.
Mm-hmm.
And
were they stealing
not as
anything?
Fun as mine.
If they weren't at Will's house, let's hear what some of them are saying. Donna Mello Stanley, she says, well, 20 hours without electric and 4 hours digging the car out. Ice and heat on, a sore back, reading, knitting, and board games. All right, turned into a positive.
When did Meg check on you, Donna? This morning?
I tried to check on as many people as I could. Lindsay Costa, she says, all good here in Warwick, never lost anything.
That's great.
Cooked up a storm. Friends had no power, so came to stay and eat. Kind of relaxing not to have to rush anywhere, and no guilt that I wasn't out doing something I should have been instead of being a couch potato.
I bet her friends were wanted.
I wanted my friends over. They were glad they were there.
Iris Golden Jasuli says, still no electricity, TV, or internet. Definitely not over yet.
Ooh. Hope you have heat.
Right. Sarah Lee Rodriguez, she says, I enjoyed every moment of it. All right. We made a snowman on Friday, awesome snow for it, before the winds and the snow picked up. Saturday, my household and our dogs played with the snow, making snow angels, taking pictures, and running around. What better to do when you're snowed in?
They found
Sounds
some
fun.
Yeah.